another edition of Romero on the Right.
For today's Romero on the Right, I would like to say it would be short and sweet, but I'd be lying on both counts. Might be a longer one than I normally record. There's nothing sweet about the state budget. How can so many people deny they didn't know what was happening? We got the governor, John Bel Edwards, says, I didn't know it was this bad. Members of the legislature, I didn't know it was this bad, even though I was a part of the problem. And then they're all starting to do things like, let's blame Stephen Wagasback, president of LABBI, the Louisiana Association of Business and Industry, because he lobbied for so many tax breaks for business. Seems like that's his job, to help business. The fact that the legislature went along with so much of it leads me to believe they were in collusion with LABBI, or they're just totally ignorant or don't want to know any better. How about people in the legislature say, you know what, we made a mistake the last 4 years, the last 8 years, whatever it was, we should have been cutting services and worrying about how to generate revenue instead of giving more services to everybody using one-time money, rainy day funds. And now we get down to where we have to threaten people with no LSU football so we can get new taxes. This is really a sad, sad state of affairs. And, you know, we get people like Karen Carter Peterson saying Stephen Wagasback is not credible. He is. He's credible. He's doing what he's supposed to be doing for his organization. You, Karen Carter Peterson, as part of the state legislature, didn't know what you were doing, obviously, for 8 years. John Bel Edwards in the legislature didn't know the budget was this bad. Wait a minute. You helped put the budget through while Bobby Jindal was governor, and you voted on the budget one way or the other. We've got to have special sessions every year to address the budget deficit. If I remember correctly, Kathleen Blanco left a surplus of $1 billion. How do you go through $1 billion and add nearly another billion in less than 8 years, Bobby Jindal? I've said it before, and I'll say it now, and I'll say it many times, I'm sure. Bobby Jindal should be brought to trial on criminal charges for wasting that $1 billion of our money. Bobby Jindal is the criminal. The rest of these people, I don't know whether they're just really that dumb or they're just trying to hide the fact that they knew what was going on and didn't fix it. We've got to cut spending. We've got to cut consulting contracts with out-of-state firms. We've also got to say, you know what, the legislature, if you don't do your job, we're going to cut some of your pay or all of your pay if we have to go through this every year. And how about you people who got those $40,000 and $30,000 raises as Bobby Jindal left office? Or Jay Darden, who went from lieutenant governor to his present position with the administration, a $40,000 raise. And the first thing he says, I didn't realize things were that bad. You were the lieutenant governor. You should know it was that bad, and you ought to give my $40,000 back. It's time that Louisiana learns we can't give everything to everybody, and we can't continue to raise taxes to pay for stuff that many of us don't use. It's time we grow up. The legislature, you should lead instead of following, because you didn't follow Bobby Jindal because he didn't lead. But nobody in the legislature led except for John Alario, and you see where that got us. Thanks for watching Romero on the Right. Please hit the subscribe button below. See you next Friday at 5 here on News Talk 96.5 KPEL.